Hello. Today we are going to discuss about the surgical treatment for the cure of sinusitis and polyp in nose. Doctors recommend the surgery of sinus only if the over-the-counter drugs or when prescribed medicines fail to relieve symptoms of chronic sinusitis. Commonly used drugs are aspirin, ibuprofen, amoxicillin, etc. Over-the-counter medicines are very popular nowadays, such as Otrivin, Vicks, etc. Sinus operation is never advised as a primary or best treatment to cure sinusitis. Surgeons can correct structural problems within the sinus and remove polyps. And this can further reduce facial pressure and pain a patient is suffering from. It helps in restoring your sense of smell, and that too is very local, and making your breath easier. But all this comes with a strong warning that sinusitis has greater chances to come again. Moreover, there are risk factors associated with surgery of sinusitis. Most popular form of sinus surgery, which is used nowadays, is endoscopic sinus surgery, ESS. This surgery is done using a nasal endoscope. The endoscope, which is inserted by a surgeon through the nostrils. It is attached to a miniature camera and light source. During surgery, images of this nasal passage and sinuses are transmitted from the endoscope to a monitor. The surgeon uses these images from a CT scan as a roadmap to help guide the surgery based on the individual structure of sinuses. So now you can understand how precise this surgery is. Endoscopic sinus surgery typically takes about 2 to 3 hours. Sinus surgery has many risks and complications. All we want is to impart knowledge among the patients suffering from sinusitis and create awareness about the possible risk or dangers of sinus surgery. So, the first possible risk is the failure to resolve the sinus infection, or the recurrence of sinus problems or polyps, as there are chances for this surgery to fail because this surgery does not resolve the root cause. Second risk is the bleeding. Sometimes it's observed that there is excessive bleeding during the process. Third, the chronic nasal drainage or excessive dryness is also one of the side effects of the surgery. It is always found that sometimes patient requires second surgery, and this surgery is more painful than the first one. There is always a requirement for the allergy evaluation, treatment, and so many kinds of tests. There is a failure to resolve associated sinus or nasal headaches. So you see that headaches never get resolved with the surgery. The patient or physician may require consultation with another specialist, such as a neurologist, because there are increased risk and damage to the eye and its associated structures. More important, that there is increased risk to the damage of the base of the skull, because you can see that endoscope will enter through this area and there can be brain abscess or leakage. Permanent numbness of the upper teeth, palate or face is also observed after surgery. Nasal obstruction due to failure to control infection or polyp after the surgery is done, because you need a lot of management once the surgery is done. Prolonged pain and impaired healing and the need for repeated hospitalization is one of the features you can see after surgery. Failure to restore or worsening of the sense of smell, which is commonly seen that after a surgery, patients loses their sense of smell, is found in this surgery So our advice is to follow the path of surgery only when everything fails. On contrary, homeopathy has the potential to resolve sinusitis and polyp in nose. All it depends is at what stage of sinusitis a patient is brought to a homeopathic clinic. Often, homeopathy is used as the last resort and it gives miraculous results. Just think, if homeopathy is used as the first line treatment and not as a last, how good it can be. So, my advice, with homeopathy, you can avoid antibiotics, you can avoid lots of painkillers and their side effects, and more important, you can avoid this gruesome, painful surgery. Thank you.